decisions, John?
Not
a trick question.
I think when it comes to handling the children, I think we're probably slightly more dominant. I think when any of the real big decisions that need to be made, I think it's fairly shared.
Yeah.
And but I think it's the other way.
He makes the rugby decision.
I make the rugby decision. But I think, you know, we're a pretty good team. There's not a dominant figure.
The next question. How's your Afrikaans, John?
My Afrikaans.
Yeah.
My Afrikaans isn't great, but the players think I don't know anything. I know when they're talking about me. But no, it's not great. But the kids are learning Afrikaans, which is great. But no, it's not great.
Picked up a few bits and pieces. Yeah.
Only the bad language.
Of all the players that you've coached, who stands out for you?
That's such a tough question. You know, I've had the benefit of coaching Springboks and All Blacks. I've really got a soft spot for Manonu, outstanding player, and Hamula, I really enjoyed. It's really, really too many. I've just got such a outstanding relationship with all the boys, and I've just been blessed with so much talent to coach. We could do Collins and Rodney Suialu, I've been involved with Tana Imanga, Kushikawa, and even had a short stint with Jonah London in Wellington, and over here, of course, all the Shark Stars, and a little bit of Springboks as well. So, John Smith was fantastic to deal with while he was here. Good man. And all the up and down coming guys like the Pat Lambies and the Fun Stains as well. So they're all just unique in their own way.
It actually hasn't. It was far too disciplined for my liking. And he always just seems to know when enough's enough. He eats a lot, but that's natural. And he trains hard. So, it hasn't changed too much, I must be honest, eh?
No, I enjoy all the basics, simple foods really. A bit of a meat and potatoes man, the veggies.